Father God, we just thank you, we praise you, we give you all the glory. And Lord, we do welcome you here. I don't even say invite you here anymore, for you are already here, and we thank you, Lord Jesus.
It's so good to be back. Yes. Isn't it good to be back? We miss you guys. It just seems like it's been like 2 months. I hope all is well. I hope everyone's had a wonderful holidays and lots of family and good food. I pray that the Lord really was your main focus, that all of you are blessed and well. And we're so glad to be back in the house. So let's all just praise the Lord together. Amen.
Amen. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
There ain't no grave gonna hold my body down. There ain't no grave gonna hold my body down. When I hear that trumpet sound, I'm gonna rise up out of the ground. There ain't no
starting off.
Well, shame is a prison as cruel as a grave. Well, shame is a robber and he's come to take my name. Well, love is my redeemer, lifting me up from the ground. Well, love is the power where my freedom song is found. There ain't no grave gonna hold my body down. There ain't no grave gonna hold my body down. When I hear that trumpet sound, I'm gonna rise up out of the ground. There ain't no smooth and velvet tongue, yes he is. And fear is a tyrant, he's always telling me to run. But love is a resurrection, and love is a trumpet sound. Love is my weapon, I'm gonna take my giants down. There ain't no grave between death and life. And there on the tree, the Lamb of God was crucified. And he went on down to hell. He took back every key. And he rose up as a lion. And he set all captives free. There ain't no grave time it is.
time to rise up. Hallelujah.
Well, since you
walked out
on.
Of the grave I'm walking to.
Yeah.
Well, since you walked out of the grave I'm walking to. Well, since you walked out of the grave I'm walking to. Well, since you walked out of the grave I'm walking to. Well, since you walked out of the grave I'm walking to. Well, since you walked out of the grave I'm walking to. There ain't no your resurrection, Lord, that this earth, this enemy has no power over us because you paid that price. You took back every key that the enemy had taken from us and gave it back to your people. And thank you, Lord, that you have given us that power in restoration, in life, over death. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Just to let you know, we brought some flags over here. If anybody wants to worship and just waving those flags, get exalting our Lord and Savior. Hallelujah. And somebody's going over here, I don't know if I'm going to do this. You are the Holy One. You are the mighty God. You are the Holy One of Israel.
You are the Holy One. You are a mighty God. You are the Holy One of Israel.
You are the Holy One.
You are a mighty God. You are the Holy One of Israel. You are the Holy One. You are a mighty God. You are the Holy One of Israel.
You are our Thank you, Lord.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Oh, the Lord is so good. He's so good. Hallelujah. You are the Holy One. Hallelujah.
Focus in on the Lord. Just give Him all our focus, because this is all about Him, giving Him glory, giving Him honor, giving Him praise. Thou art worthy, O Lord, to receive glory and honor and power, for Thou hast created all things. And for Thy pleasure they are and were created. Great and marvelous are Thy works,
Lord God Almighty.
Just and true, Thou King of saints,
Lord God Almighty.
Worthy is the Lamb forever and ever. Worthy is the Lamb. Worthy is the Lamb. Worthy is the Lamb forever and ever. Worthy. Worthy. Great and marvelous are Thy works,
Lord God Almighty.
Just and true, Thou King of saints,
Lord God Almighty.
Worthy is the Lamb forever and ever. they sung a new song. Same. It's not moving. And they sung a new song, saying, "Thou art worthy to take the book and to open the seals thereof. For thou wast slain and hast redeemed us to God by the blood out of every kindred and tongue and people and nation. And he has made us unto our God kings and priests." And I'm going to say that again. "And he has made us unto our God kings and priests." What does that mean? We are kings and priests because we are of royal lineage. He is our Father. He is the King of all kings. And we are kings and priests. And we shall reign on the earth. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Holy, holy Lord God Almighty. Holy, holy Lord God Almighty.
Can't you just feel the war cry? Can't you just feel the stirring of the Holy Spirit saying, "You were created for such a time as this"? Don't you feel the Spirit just moving? Hallelujah! Hallelujah! So excited to be in this hour where we can glorify Yeshua. Hallelujah!
Jacob, great I am.
Son of Man, voice of many waters, song of heaven's throne, louder than the thunder, make your glory known.
Hail, hail, Lion of Judah, let the lion roar.
Hail, hail, Lion of Judah, let the lion roar. Hail, hail, Lion of Judah, let the lion roar.
Hail, hail, Lion of Judah, let the lion roar.
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 Pride on Zion, prophet spoke, our Messiah, flesh and bone.
You alone are worthy to open up the scrolls. Like a lamb you suffered, but the lion has a roar.
Hail, hail, Lion of Judah, let the lion roar.
Hail, hail, Lion of Judah, let the lion roar.
Hail, hail, Lion of Judah, let the lion roar.
Hail, hail, Lion of Judah, let the lion roar.
That shout in the wilderness, prepare the way of the Lord. As John the Baptist said, cried out in the wilderness, prepare the way for the Lord. Prepare the way of the Lord. We are coming into that time. Prepare the way of the Lord. His glory will reign upon this place. His spirit will move upon the earth, across the earth, as the waters cover the seas. Prepare the way of the Lord.
Prepare the way, prepare the way of the Lord, prepare the way, prepare the way of the Lord, prepare the way, prepare the way of the Lord, prepare the way, prepare the way of the Lord, prepare the way, prepare the way of the Lord, prepare the way, prepare the way of the Lord.
That they are nothing, to believe that they have no power. Those valleys, those people in the valleys are being raised up, and those people who put them high, themselves high and exalted over everything else, those mountains are being taken down right now in Jesus' name as we sing.
Doesn't know the time we are in. But as we focus and keep our eyes upon the Lord, though everything around us is crumbling, falling, we will dwell in that secret place under the shadow of his wings.
The song we're going to sing, I will say, it's by Shane and Shane. And the very first time I heard this song, it stopped me dead in my tracks. Where he says, the Lord of hosts is with us. And it says, where else would I want to be but with the Lord of hosts? So as we sing this, enter into the high places, enter into the heavenlies. He's calling us to come up hither. He's calling us into Psalms 91,
into his
to abide
dwelling
in
place.
Him. Where else would we want to be?
Faith. crowns the chariots with fire. Lord, amongst you with us in the fire, with us as a shelter, with us in the storm. You will lead us through the fiercest battle. Oh, where else would we go but with the Lord of hosts?
God of Jacob, fierce and great, you lift your voice to speak. The earth that bows and all the mountains move into the sea.
Oh Lord, you know the hearts of men, still you let them live. Oh God, who makes the mountains melt, come rest so way the mountains move into the sea, the nations rage.
I know my God is in control.
The oceans roar, you are the Lord of all, the one who calms the wind and waves and makes my heart be still. Gives way, the mountains move into the sea, the nations rage.
I know my God is in control.
Oceans roar, you are the Lord of all,
the one who calms the winds and waves and makes my heart be still.
only found in one place. Take me into the Holy of Holies. Take me in by the blood of the Lamb. Take me into the Holy of Holies. Take the coal, touch my lips, here I am. Take me past the outer courts into the holy place, past the brazen altar. Lord, I want to see your face. Pass me by the crowds of people, and the priests will sing your praise. I hunger and thirst for your righteousness, and it's only found in one place. Take me into the Holy of Holies. Take me in by the blood of the Lamb. Take me into the Holy of Holies. Take the coal, touch my lips, here I am. Take me into the Holy of Holies. Take me in by the blood of the Lamb. Take me
and round your throne,
casting crowns and bowing low, giving glory and honor to him who sits on the throne.
Round and round and round your throne,
casting crowns and bowing low, giving glory and honor to him who sits on the throne.
Looks like jasper and sardine stone,
rainbow colors about your throne. The floor before you as a sea of glass,
and lamps with burning fire burn day and night.
Round and round and round your throne, casting crowns and bowing low, giving glory and honor to him who sits on the throne. Round and round and round your throne, casting crowns and bowing low, giving glory and honor to him who sits on the throne. Giving glory and honor to him who sits on the throne.
Elders wearing crowns of gold,
dressed in white linen robes,
and the seven spirits of God before your throne.
With many faces.
The song that we're going to sing next, this song came complete Wednesday. So we're just be blessed. I pray that it takes you to a place, because I believe in this hour. How many of you really, really feel that we're in the last days? How many of you find yourself weeping more than you ever have? Actually see certain circumstances a different way now. We see it with compassion. This song here is in the book of Revelations, chapter 22, where it says, the spirit of the bride say, come. And it says, let them that hear say, come. That's us. That we're going to be called. God wants us to start calling many to come and drink the water of living water. This song is titled, Come Freely. He wants them to come freely. He wants each and every one of us to come freely. He's not saying come and just drink once. He said to come freely. Come freely and drink of this living water, and you will never thirst again.
From the water of life, come freely. So welcome again, everybody, and welcome to SoCal Connect, who's joining us online today in our combination service, and everyone who's joining us online. We're so happy to be with you and to be praising and worshiping the Lord together with you. And we have lots of good things to report to you this week. Maybe we'll head into the announcements real quick and receive the Lord's tithes and offerings. And to give you a few announcements this week, we invite you to like us and share this video on Facebook. Next one. And to subscribe to our YouTube channel, Grace Christian Church with Pastor G and PJ at Grace Out Loud is the key line. I love it when it's praise and worship and I come out hoarse. That's the best kind. That's what it is, being hoarse from singing. I love that. All right, what do we have next? Oh, couple big thank yous that we want to share. We want to thank you for praying for Pastor G. Came through surgery with all the green lights going on. Amen. Thank you. He had knee surgery on Tuesday morning. Everything went well, and he's here in the house with us today. They let him out earlier than was expected, and so far he's been a good patient, so we'll keep that up. So far, Rodney's keeping an eye on him, and he has a funny story, actually, to tell about Rodney. So, so many thank yous. And then also thank you for those who gave and who are continuing to give to the Rachel's Hope offering. We have, offerings are still coming in, but we have, for Rachel's Hope, together we have raised over $1,300. Yes, praise God. And supplies that were here, that were brought last week. And then Don Anderson has volunteered to coordinate moving forward to put together some other needs that Rachel's Hope has for their Caring Pregnancy Center. So thank you so much for that. And then today after service, everyone's invited to the potato and salad bar in the fellowship hall in the lower level. There's plenty of food. Please come on down. It's smelling great already. And we're so happy to be with you today. Let's take a minute and turn to our giving now. We've been worshiping the Lord with our worship and giving through worship, and now we'll worship through our giving. And so if we're here in the building, there is the giving station in the back. You may make your checks to Grace Christian Church, or you can use that QR code there, or text to the number 77977, text to connect. Text connect to Grace to 77977. Or you may also use PayPal and send to gccalbertlee.com. And for those of you who like to mail it in, you can send it to P.O. Box 1, Albert Lee, Minnesota 56007. So let's take a moment to prepare the Lord's tithe and our offering. And let's pray. Lord, we thank you. Thank you for your goodness, your mercies. Thank you for just your never-ending kindness and love for us, Lord. Lord, you freely give to us, and we freely give to you, Lord. And so bless each one today, Lord, as we worship you through our giving. In Jesus' name, amen. All right. We'll have a little bit of music, and we'll take a moment just to...
Somebody shout a good hallelujah. Oh, come on. You can do better than that.
Hallelujah.
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 Amen. Amen. I want to say with PJ, thank you from the bottom of our hearts for praying for me. I don't know how many of you have ever been through a surgery like this, but it weighs on your mind and your nerves and all of that. And I was a very, very grumpy camper leading up all the way to the surgery. And then when they woke me up, I was extremely combative and ordinary. You know, completely opposite me normally. And I grabbed the male nurse by the arm and I demanded to know, where's Rodney? And he said, oh, yeah, everything's okay, man. Everything's cool. Rodney's. I said, no, where is Rodney Norris? And he said, oh, Rodney Norris, he's okay, man. And I wouldn't let him go, so they sent a lady nurse in. And I said, look at me in the eyes. I said, I am in control of my faculties. I'm not crazy. I'm not hallucinating. And she said, okay, okay, you're okay. Just breathe. I said, am I having a heart attack? I said, somebody is on my chest trying to choke me. And I said, go find my wife, Dr. PJ, and tell her to get Rodney Norris in here right now.
What can you do? What can you do?
And so I said, Rodney Norris is the head of my security team, and whoever is trying to choke me, Rodney's going to take care of him right now. And so I kept pointing to my right here, and then finally they realized that Rodney is, in fact, a real individual. So I want you to know, when you are down and out, you can call on this GCC safety team, and they got your back.
That's
amen.
Right. You're bigger than life.
Somebody say amen. Amen. I want Peggy to go join PJ right there because the Lord gave her a very strong prophetic word for me, and I want you to hear that today.
Thank you. Well, good morning, everybody. So while we were worshiping, by the way, thank you. I know there's more worship to come, but wow, the presence of God is just in this place and beautiful worship, and thank you for that. And during that worship, maybe the second song or third song, I was standing there, and I could see Pastor George back there. I couldn't see him physically, but I knew I could see him there. And the Lord said this to him, and I went back and shared this with him during the music time. But blessings to you, mighty man of God. And just as Shammah, one of the mighty men of David, there's three mighty men of David, stood in that field and determined himself to stand firm in that field and fight with the help of God. And he won many, many battles there with individuals. I can't remember how many thousands. That's Pastor George. So be determined, Pastor George, to stand in that field. And God is with you. And I actually looked up the meaning of the name Shammah, and it means God is there. God is with you. So as you stand in that field, God is with you, and as it's been impressed upon me from the beginning that you are in God's hands. And there is no reason to fear or worry or anything when you're in God's hands, right? So mighty man of God, thank you. It's nice to have a mighty man of God as our pastor, isn't it? So thank you so much.
Praise God. Praise God.
Thank you, Peggy.
I receive that encouragement. And I want to say thank you to everyone that has messaged us. The first day back, Don and Kathy came and they shoveled off the driveway and they put salt down.
Yes.
And they brought us food and came in to the room and prayed for me and encouraged me.
Yes.
I want you to know Kathy and Don have been going through the ringer in the past couple of years, but especially the past few months. This is an unstoppable team.
Amen.
They have a beautiful
Amen.
Marriage,
yes.
beautiful spirit, and I didn't want them to come and shovel, but they came and shoveled and put down salt, brought us food and prayed for me. And then last night, Michael and Jody Johnson came and prayed for us and encouraged us and brought us money for takeout. Jody had gone through knee surgery, and so they know what that's like. But let me just encourage you. You know, when you're going through something, whether it's health or finance or spiritual, the enemy will try to take advantage of that. And the enemy came against me so strongly. And one of the things he tried to tell me was that he was going to kill me through this surgery. And I had to battle through that through prayer and the Word of God. But let me tell you something. Just at the logical level, you can destroy the enemy's lies. Because I got to thinking about that, you know, most people don't die with a knee surgery. In fact, most people don't, there's not even many people dying on the surgery table at all anymore in this country. Even open heart surgery, they stop the heart, they work on the heart, and then they turn that machine back on and the heart comes back to life. So I spoke out openly to the enemy. I said, let me tell you something, sucker. The data is against you. So you use the wrong information at the wrong time against the wrong guy. And I said, you know, if you had the power to kill me, you could have taken me out in the womb. You should have taken me out in 2010 when my appendix ruptured and I almost died and almost died of infection. So since you're a coward, since you flinched, you've missed. God gives me the victory. I'm going to go in. I'm getting a new knee. I'm coming out with the victory. I can tell you today, God always brings his people through to victory.
Amen.
Always, 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 always.
Amen.
And let me tell you something. God doesn't do everything by prayer. Sometimes God uses medical science. He uses very smart people that have gone to school that know what they're doing. And let me say this also. God will use medications to help us. And you got to take those medications. I don't like taking narcotics, but I got some very, very smart people on my care team. That's Angie Olson. That is Kathy Anderson.
Yeah.
That was Jody Johnson.
Yeah.
And several people that know that you got to get ahead of the pain.
Yes.
I think Tammy also. I'm a little foggy this morning, but let me tell you something. When you're in pain, you got prayer, and then you got human beings that know what they're doing. Let them help you. Let them help you. Let us help each other. We are all in this together. And you know that faithful church attendance is extremely important to me. And I told my wife, I have one goal. I had about five goals, but my number one goal was to take that walker and work my way into the sanctuary last night. And when I did, I plopped down in this little chair back here. PJ turned on some praise and worship music, and we had church all by ourselves in this beautiful sanctuary. I'm a little emotional right now, but I want you to know from the bottom of my heart, I love every single one of you. I'm in your corner. In a few weeks, I'm going to be up again, strong again by the grace of God, and we're going to win this city to Christ.
Amen.
We're going to do
Hallelujah.
The work of God,
Hallelujah.
And God is going to be glorified.
Thank you, Lord.
Amen. So
Amen.
Shabbat is going to wrap up with one song. Let's
Or two.
Yeah, because it's about time. Okay, I'll shut up.
If you'd like to send your mic back up.
Yeah, I sure
And
will.
Then we'll go ahead and stand again for our final couple of worship songs here. Thank you for being with us today and worshiping the Lord together with us. Amen. Thank you, Shabbat.
Okay, the words aren't going to be here, so don't worry about the words. Okay.
Switched it up.
Yep. And if you've got the CD, you'll recognize the songs.
And if you don't have the CD, buy the CD.
I wasn't trying to give a plug, but thank you. In the rain of life's sorrows and pain, I hear the thunder, the voices of shame. Turn from you, you've
fun, isn't he? Not only is he good, but he's fun. I was saying to Nate one night, I said, you know, I really would like the Lord to give me a song about how it felt when I met him, how to recapture that. And I said, you know, he's hearing what I'm saying right now anyway, so then, you know, I'm just going to declare that. The very next morning, the Lord gave me this song, and it was just like that. So enjoy.
When I got down on my knees, I met mercy. I met mercy. And it poured out just like rain. Let it rain. Let it rain. Let it rain. And it poured out just like rain. Like rain.
your hands unto the Lord. Shout a praise unto the Lord. Hallelujah. Nate and Jeannie and Dan and John and Teresa, thank you. Shabbat. Put your hands together for Shabbat worship, William. They are such an amazing, amazing worship team. But I want you to know they are now part of Grace Christian Church. They are considering this as their church family. And we welcome them. We love them. And we will, PJ and I will be serving as their pastors. And we are so humbled by that.
Praise
and
God.
We just welcome them. Let me say this to you. I'll pray over the food. It smells so good down there. And I want to say thank you again to all of our teams, to our elders, to our deacons, to our safety team, to the technical team, the hospitality team that has been downstairs working since early this morning. Everyone, our church custodian, God bless you.
Yes.
You are our family. PJ and I don't have a mom and dad. We don't have grandpas and grandmas, but we have you. And you are our blood by the blood of Jesus. Can you say amen?
Amen.
So we love you. I'm just going to tell you some things that I'm craving right now in case any of you want to make a Walmart run. There are these little sugar-free, what's it called, baby?
Jell-O.
These little sugar-free Jell-O packs, and I need some Cool Whip topping on top of that. Rodney said, there goes the sugar-free. And I need some Roma tomatoes. I think that's all I need right now.
A cucumber.
Cucumbers. I need some cucumbers. So
Ms. Tiffany said she's going to
Walmart. Work that through PJ or Peggy or somebody on the
and
team.
And if you haven't had a chance yet to sign Pastor G's picture Matt for his birthday and Janet's 90th birthday card, please sign those on your way down today.
Amen. Lord, thank you for Angie Kay and the beautiful team that she has assembled that are serving downstairs. May everything just be so beautiful, Lord, as the people fellowship and get to know each other and just bond, and that we would continue to grow as true family. As true family, God. Help us stay true to the mission of this church, that is to love people the way that Jesus loves them, and to try to help the hurt right out of their lives, and to disciple people for Jesus, Lord. Again, I thank you, Lord, for all of the beautiful people that have made it to the house today and all of those that joined us online. I pray a special healing touch for Carol today, Lord, that you would heal that back, send away all that pain, God, give her answers to that. Sandy Vaughn, we remember those in the nursing home, Janet Stadheim, Jean Carew, we remember Annabelle Hutchinson today, God. Thank you, Lord, for all of your goodness. Thank you for life, thank you for salvation, and thank you for this beautiful church, God, in the name of Jesus. Amen.
Amen.